Hey guys, welcome to The Market is Open. Elon Musk recently announced breakthrough battery innovations at Tesla's Battery Day event. He discussed how the gigafactories will be smaller and cheaper to make, yet be able to have enormously high battery production output in the coming years. Tesla is planning to have 100 gigawatt hours on their own in 2 years' time, which is almost triple what their current supplier Panasonic has been providing for all of Tesla's US vehicles. Elon Musk outlined the plan for bringing the price per kilowatt hour of battery storage down 56% with the help of their new battery cells, smaller, more efficient factories, and much better integration into the vehicle itself. And thirdly, Tesla's Battery Day showed investors the roadmap for Tesla to accelerate themselves ahead of the competition with the updates I just mentioned, along with new silicon anode technology and high-efficiency battery cathode materials. This results in a massive 54% range increase in their new batteries, and also a large chunk of that increase would still apply to their current battery chemistries as well. For example, lithium iron phosphate batteries, which they'll start by using in their China Model 3, are actually low-cost batteries. The materials are abundant, but they have low energy density. However, with Tesla's new efficiencies that they'll bring to the table, they could still see about a 30% increase in range even with these types of batteries. That said, one major question still remained after Battery Day, which was very much on people's minds going into the event, and that was, what about the million-mile battery that Elon Musk has been talking about for years now? Tesla made no mention of this at Battery Day, which made people question if it was still on the table, and if Tesla actually had the technology to bring a million-mile battery to their vehicles. However, it looks like Tesla's battery research partner Jeff Dahn at Dalhousie University might in fact have a 2 million mile battery in store, which would be an absolute game changer. So let's have a look. But before we begin, please hit the bell button to subscribe and be notified of upcoming Tesla videos, and smash the like button at any time to help support this video. We'd super appreciate that. You can also support the channel at patreon.com/themarketisopen, and we give a shout out to our patrons at the end of each video. Also, stop using Yahoo Finance and stop using Google Finance and have a look at our website, themarketisopen.com, where we have instant stock quotes and financial data for every single company going back 9 years, and it's all freely available. The million-mile battery, which Elon Musk first spoke about years ago, is representing the distance you can drive a vehicle before the battery degrades and needs to be replaced. This is very similar to an iPhone battery, for example, where after a few years of usage, even if the phone is charged up to 100%, its overall capacity has slowly started to degrade and the battery dies much more quickly, rendering it not that useful. Current Tesla batteries and vehicles that we see today last about 300,000 miles, which for many people is the lifetime of their vehicles anyways, so why is that important to increase it to a million miles or 2 million miles or more? It's important for a number of main reasons. One is that it would immediately increase the value of an electric vehicle. The battery is the most expensive part of the vehicle, at least for the time being, and no one wants to have to pay to replace that. So even for used vehicles with say 200,000 miles on it, with a 2 million mile battery, it would still have 1.8 million miles left to go. So it's sure to retain its value much better than a comparable vehicle with only 300,000 miles of total capacity, followed by repairs and replacement costs. Or at least this high longevity battery can be repurposed to be used as a storage battery on the grid, for example. The second thing is that Tesla is planning semi-trucks and robo-taxis, as we've discussed in previous videos. Both of these types of vehicles will have far more usage than normal, as they'll be operating all day and they might need to charge up every day or two under high usage. Contrast that to a regular EV, which you might fully charge once per week or once every 2 weeks. Battery degradation is mainly attributed to charging and discharging a battery over and over. This creates microscopic cracks which start to break down the battery over time, causing this degradation. These 300,000 mile batteries really are only good for about 1500 charge cycles, whereas with 10,000 charge cycles, you can achieve 2 million mile batteries. In an interview with Dr. Jeff Dahn, who works with Tesla at the University of Dalhousie in Halifax, and Dr. Lucas Swan, they discuss where battery technology stands today and where it's headed. Jeff Dahn starts by pointing out that in some cases, lithium-ion batteries are underestimated, and he's focusing on modern lithium-ion batteries. Using the data from this chart that he displays, he shows that they've done 3 years of testing so far with these modern lithium-ion batteries, and they're shown to have 10,000 charge cycles with very little degradation. And so he tries to answer the question, why do we need such good batteries? He talks about vehicle-to-grid and grid energy storage as potential applications. Elon Musk sort of put the damper on vehicle-to-grid, where you can use your vehicle's battery to power your house or sell power back to the grid. The reason being that if you use your car during the day, you usually need to charge it when you get home, not take more power out of it. At least for now, it doesn't make much sense with current vehicles. Jeff Dahn speaks about using it in school buses, which might make more sense, since the usage is more predictable. The school buses mainly run twice a day and can charge during the day using solar and give that power back to the grid at night while still retaining enough power for the next morning's trip. Tesla doesn't make school buses, so this is something for more in the future or for other companies to tackle. However, grid energy storage is used today with Tesla's Powerwall and Megapack. At 10,000 charge cycles with almost no degradation, the question is, how long will these cells last? Because even after 10,000 cycles, they can keep going and going. At one charge per day, it's at least 25 years, and they could keep going far beyond that. And that adds a lot of value to grid operators who have some sort of payback period on their batteries, but after the batteries pay for themselves, they don't need to be replaced. Now, under normal situations, such as using your vehicle to drive to and from work, you're not effectively stressing the batteries out as much, and they can actually last much longer. Under typical use, Jeff Dahn's data shows 15,000 cycles, so these modern lithium-ion batteries can last an extremely long time. Furthermore, they say you can repurpose vehicle batteries after the rest of the car rusts away. Now that's interesting because Tesla's cars are mostly made out of aluminum, the Cybertruck is going to be made out of stainless steel. They're going to last much longer, and I think this gives Tesla's vehicles a huge resale value. You can also turn the batteries into home or grid storage afterwards. But I think that the 2 million plus mile battery got even more important after Tesla's battery day. This is because Tesla is planning to integrate the battery pack directly into the structure of the vehicle. Previously, the battery was just sitting in the car so that it would be easier to swap out. If it's part of the structure, however, it's much more difficult, if not impossible, to swap out without cutting the whole car apart. If you can't replace the battery, then the battery better last a long time, such that it never needs to be replaced, and that seems to be the plan. Now, Dr. Lucas Swan is also on the interview, and he fields a few questions. The first is about the cooling of Tesla's 4680 batteries, and he did say that he hasn't seen them yet, but he proposes that the center of the battery looked like it could run cooling through there. So I thought that was interesting. It didn't look like Tesla would be doing that, but you never know. He also mentions that he would like to see cars that charge up in 5 minutes, similar to the time it takes to fill a gas car. That would be the final nail in the coffin for the ICE industry, but it's interesting to see that they are exploring this possibility. He says that there are a lot of technical hurdles here, but it's far from impossible. Now, it's strange that Tesla didn't mention the million mile or 2 million mile battery at battery day. One problem with a 2 million mile battery is that it makes the current 300,000 mile batteries look pretty bad. I think it's just a perception 300,000 miles is more than enough for passenger vehicles, but it could hurt the resale value of those cars in my opinion, and people might not want to buy them until the new Teslas are fitted with million mile batteries. I think Tesla will wait until they ramp up their new technology into more vehicles before telling people that the 2 million mile battery is already in all of their vehicles. It's possible that it's already there right now in all of the new vehicles that are being produced today. Tesla tends to do that, and I think it's a great strategy that will also prevent people from holding off their purchases as they wait for this higher longevity battery to hit the market at a higher scale. When they formally announce it, people will ask, well, when can I get this new type of battery? And the answer will be, right now. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please hit the like button on this video. We'd super appreciate that. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell button to be notified of upcoming Tesla content. You can support us further on Patreon at patreon.com/themarketisopen. A very special thanks to Bradford Ferguson of Halter Ferguson Financial and all of our patrons that help to support our channel. Your support helps us to continue to make great content. Thank you guys so much for watching.